Hello Gundam fans, this is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 1/100 Master Ray Turn A Gundam from the Turn A Gundam series. So this is number 100 in the Master Ray line. And, yeah, I mean, for the weird design, it looks really good. Good detail, you got all the colors in here. Sticker-wise, well, nothing really. I mean, I didn't use one for the eyes, because what's the point? Kind of hard to see. It's yellow. But yeah, they're there. You got the clear for the cockpit, which you do have a pilot inside. Oh, too close. Come on. You can do it. Focus. Focus. There we go. Neat. And then we also have the little pilot, which unfortunately you can't tell if it's Lauren or not. It's just a spacesuit. That's a little disappointing. Although the one thing you get that I am very, very happy about is you get the little cow that you can store in the chest of the Turning Gundam, which it did in the anime. Is this proportionate? That's a small cow. Yeah, definitely a small, like a calf, maybe? Whatever. Anyways, you also get a sheet of rogue transfer decals, which are, yeah, they're okay. I like the fact you actually get the Turning Gundam logo a couple times, that's neat. And the actual, number of the Turning. Cool, helmet looking thing. So, yeah. Everything holds together rather well on the kit, aside from that clear canopy on the cockpit. And it does come off and turn into its own fighter, but I want to try and do it from the bottom so I don't accidentally knock the clear piece off. It's a nice solid connection there. It doesn't come off the actual body. Now, to turn into the core fighter mode, you just kind of rotate the skirts into wings on the double hinge that it has, which does come in pegged. Not a big deal. But you kind of want to push in as you rotate it up so that you don't knock it off. And that way the pilot does rotate and faces the proper way. It's a cool little core fighter. I do like it. Even detailed underneath. So once again, when you go to turn it into the front of the garage, you want to hold that down. That's really the biggest problem with it holding together is I find that, well, actually there's two points. Also the back panels here. And well, it's the side and the little back. Because the thighs rotate, but the thing is, you go too far, it comes right off. Because they should have engineered a hinge here for this panel. Because you have this nice thigh rotation, but you can't utilize it as much as you could if this actually moved out of the way. So it's kind of annoying. But I mean, those are the only real problems I have with the overall design of the kit. Everything else, for such a weird friggin' design, it's really good. So the head is interesting, because you can actually pull it away from the neck, and then you get more of a range of motion, like up and down and side to side. Because there's a normal swivel in the actual torso. And then you just push it back down, and it's solid again. The shoulder armor, is that all the way back? Yeah, it is. Okay. Shoulder armor can move kind of away from the back panel, which also is on its own little hinge. So you get the arm pretty far forward, and also out. There's a little bit of forward and back. You can rotate at the elbow, and then also bend at two joints. It does start to look a little weird here, but I don't think it's terrible. Then you have a ball joint up here in the arm, so it can move, and then you have a ball joint in the actual wrist, which it's a different kind of way they connected it here. It's like a little cup. And you also have a set of open hands and a set, actually, just the open hands. I don't know why I thought there was another one. I think it's just to simulate when it's like flying, or when it's holding up the, like, its hands up. I did that one time. But yeah, they're nice and solid. Now these are just static hands, but then the other ones are the articulate. They have a ball jointed thumb, and now the index finger is ball jointed, but the other three are actually molded separately. Only on the one hinge at the hand, base of the hand, but that is a little different. Usually you have to separate themselves. And the torso, you do have a nice ball joint in there, and then you have a swivel in the waist. I already showed the front skirts, but they can with the two joints, and then get out of the way for the leg. Side skirts are also ball jointed. A little loose, not terrible. So they can go forward, and go back, out. Like I said, it can rotate at the thigh, but it starts to pop off the armor, so about that far, unfortunately. You do have a nice double jointed knee, and also a hinge halfway down the leg. And the thruster pieces actually move with it, so that's cool. And then the ankle, go forward and back, side to side. Some rotation, and the toes can go up and down. So yeah, it's got good articulation. I just wish, once again, those freaking armor, like, back armor of the legs really do hinder the thighs. It could be so much better if they just had given a little hinge to make these go down. But it's not a terrible thing. It's still really good articulation. Well, I already went ahead and showed off the hands. But you also have this extra piece for the chest, which is white. It just basically goes on like that. I don't remember any art of the tourney with that. Maybe there is, I just haven't seen it, but it's an option. Okay. You have the beam saber handles on the back, which are pegged in. And they are, the beam saber is actually on a track, so you slide them out. And you have a set of, they're round pink beams, but the connection is flat. So it does look pretty good. And then there's a peg hole. Because you have the peg in the hands. Only in the articulate ones, not in the open hands. So you just put them in like that. Maybe that's why the fingers can articulate, so they can actually wrap a little more naturally around the hand. Because of how it's angled there. But they hold pretty well. And then you have the shield, which it's a really funky design. I do like it. Looks like a surfboard, sort of. But you have a connection point here for the arm, which is on a track. You have the handle here, and some parts that go around the arm. These really, I think, are just for show. I'm sure they mattered in the anime, but not really here. It'll just go and pick up to the arm. Like that. And then you can just have those go around like that. And there's a shield. It's a shield. Different looking shield, but a shield. I always wish this would do something, but I don't think it does. If it had, like, a missile in it or another beam saber, I don't know. Just to serve a purpose. And then you have the beam rifle. Which, it's weird because the this panel here opens up to reveal the handle, which is nice. I like that, but it's this back panel. It opens up to reveal this piece, which I think is a dial just to adjust the power of the beam rifle. I don't really know. I can't remember. I only saw halfway through the show. It's been a while, but yeah, you can hold the handle here. I forgot that it actually opens up. That's neat. But this part here, it just comes off way too easy. There's a little tab which catches in here, but the thing is, nothing catches down below. So, I don't know, it's way too easy to pull it off. Just accidentally. I don't know. It annoys me. And it doesn't hold. It holds okay in the hand, but the thing is, the awkwardness of the shape of this rifle. I think it's best to be underneath the arm, but it can be a little tricky to do, because, I mean, it's not a super secure fit in the hand, unfortunately, so you just have to kind of work with it, kind of like that. But yeah, I mean, it's not the best in the hand, but like I said, I really do like this little cover that goes over the handle, makes it nice and clean. Now you can mount this on and the shield on the back. You get these two adapters, and this little clip around the rifle, like that, clips into these little indents. And I love how they did this, because you can't see it, but you have the panels I mentioned before, they open up and there's little holes here. And so they'll actually pay like that, and then you can just cover that back down. So you have the mounting point, but you don't see it there. And same thing with the shield. You got this arm here. So just mount this one in here. Like that. Goes over. And then it has the same kind of hole as the arm does. So we can just... Oh my god, I just realized it took his arm panel. That is funny. Oh man. Okay, anyways, just peg it into the connection point, and there we go. The weapons are on the back. And he probably wants the arm piece back. There we go. Good zoom. And then finally, well, for the the actual weapon accessories, we have the Gundam hammer, which it looks like the one from the ARC-782. I don't think it's exactly the same. And it goes. This is probably the best holding weapon that it has. Like, it holds this thing for days, literally. I've had it in here for days, and it works really well once you get it in, of course. There we go. Very cool. I really like this weapon, actually. I say it's my favorite. Yeah, it's cool. And then you have, I think, let's get these out of the way. You're not going to be able to see it. And I must rip those off while I'm at it. But I believe, I don't really know because I haven't, like I said, seen all the anime, but I think these little panels are to show off where the Moonlight Butterfly comes from. I don't know. I always thought it was the legs. But I think it's the back here. These panels do open up. Granted, it can be a little hard to do. But they do open. Why don't you open? Are you open? Ah, well, they do open. I don't know why they've been a pain today. They do open up. And they have little holes in there, which I assume you could attach. Do they ever have a P-Bandai adapter for the Master Grade? They did for the High Grade. Can't remember. But then the other cool thing is the missile pods in the chest. Now, to access them, you could just take your finger at the top here and pull out, but they give you the stand adapter, which actually acts as a way to push that forward. So this little piece here is where the stand goes, which is a little different. Usually it's in the crotch, not in the back. And then you just take this, put it in, and it pushes the chest out. And so now you have the caster, which reminds me of the Dendrobium. And then you just open up the panels. Now the middle panel is a little touchy. It's not too hard to get it to fall off, but there you go. You have the missiles in there. Very nicely detailed in the chest, which I don't think you can really see. The light in there. There you go. Kind of see that? Very detailed. For just an inner chest piece. And then these two, I think, are they also missiles or are they beam guns? I'm not 100%. But they're also there. And so let me get the, I know I was going to do that. I had it upside down. But you can have these open. So let's say it's firing its missiles in the chest. Or, you can take the top panel out and remove the missiles, which is a little hard to do. I suggest doing it like this. And you can place the oh-so-important cow into the chest. Just slide right in to there. And that is glorious. I love it so much. You have no idea. Like, I do love that. The fact that it can do that. Am I the only one who wanted to see a scene where it accidentally fired the cow out of the chest? That'd be funny. But, didn't happen. But still, that is a cool thing. It can do that. Like, just for no reason, just because it can. I'll put the missiles in later. So yeah, those are the accessories. Really good. I like all of them. Especially the chest with the cow. Like, the fact that you get the cow, I love it. So yeah, accessories, pretty good. Well, let's start off with the, I guess the end of the timeline for Universal Century and the beginning with the Gundam anyways. So R72 and Turn A. And you know, I kind of thought Turn A was a lot taller than this. It's not as tall as I was expecting. Although, I mean, it's been a while. I boxed up my old 100 high grade years ago, so it's been a while since I've compared, like, this, my master grade scale. And then, how about one that's a little shorter? The Victory 2. And then, the other master grade from Turn A Gundam. A lot heavier, too. The Turn-X. Now that guy's a biggie. Wow, I didn't realize how big it was compared to the Turn A Gundam until now. So, yeah, that is the Turn A Gundam. Really like it. Like, I've never been a huge fan of the design, but I do like this model a lot. It does a lot of things right. It looks good, for being the Turn A Gundam. Poses are good, aside from the panel hindering the thighs. And, like, that clear piece does come off. It was actually pretty good today, but it does come off too easily. And it would have been nice if the accessories were a little more secure in the hands. It's not terrible, though. You can work around it. But no, it's a great kit. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.